This is from part 1 of chapter 18 of the Avatamsaka Sutra.
如诸菩萨摩诃萨常勤修行，灭除一切无明黑暗，降伏魔怨，制诸外道，永敌一切烦恼心垢，悉能成就一切善根。
Furthermore, bodhisattvas, mahasattvas always diligently cultivate.
Afflictions are in my mind. Many years of cultivation have made my clothes dirty, and I cannot focus on the heart sutra that I am reading. I must sit down and settle my mind.
And eradicate all delusions and darknesses. Scene 2. Subdue the demonic resentment. And rise above non-Buddhist traditions. Scene 3. Forever clean up all the afflictions and filth in the heart. Scene 4, and can bring to fruition all the good roots.
Hello? Is this better? It's worse to me. Okay, if you've seen our team this past week, especially the first 4 or 5 days, you've probably seen them being kind of dizzy. And if you've walked past our table, you've probably heard us talk about duality, non-duality, thusness, Buddha body, Dharma body, Buddha nature, confusion and delusion. And like those words were basically most of the words in our text. So everyone was getting kind of dizzy. And we thought, how do we present this to you? Well, you know, because basically what we're working on is this 6th, 7th century text by Master Jizang, which is actually kind of like, you know, an intense philosophical debate on, you know, the nature of non-duality. So we'll give you a little peek into that world. We made a little documentary. We got some footage from back in, you know, back in the 6th century.
Nature's covered, and we are the body, and that's dust. Does it work? Hello? Hello? Okay, so when we prepared our presentation, we kind of forgot that we are in the US and that a presentation can be a show. So we made a really boring presentation. But then we thought that, or not boring, it's very interesting, very deep, but but our presentation of it was not so exciting. But then we thought because our translation of the Vimalakirti is a very long project. It won't be finished in a long time. But we have been doing some other projects, among others, this one. And we thought, just to give you kind of a sense of the Norwegian language, we will just read some pages for you. And what's really wonderful about children's books is that you have the illustrations. So, for example, Mara. We don't have that word in Norwegian. People don't recognize it. But if you have a picture, the children, they will understand. So we've been relying on the relationship between text and illustrations in translation. Yeah, translating this one. And just in Norway, there are some people translating Buddhist texts, but it's on a very high academic level. They are looking at old birch manuscripts and trying to figure out what's in the missing places. So I went to a Sanskrit class, and that was what they were doing. It was on a very high level. I have a picture of it. It's this one. So they were very kind and let me, sit by and listen, but it's on another level. It was way above what I could manage. That's in Oslo. Yeah, there's an Institute of Philology in Oslo, which is very good. They do. It's a professor called Jens Brorvik. He's an amazing person. He knows all the ancient languages. So in the future, I'll hopefully be able to learn from him. But now let's read. Maybe we should change sides. Snow-covered peaks. What are bodhisattvas like?
Snødekte fjelltopper. Hva en bodhisattva?
Okay, I'll read.
We need one more? Okay.
Bodhisattva. Bodhi means enlightenment.
Where are the nine? Bodhisattva, Buddha, Bodhi betyr opplysning.
Sattva means living being.
Sattva betyr levende vesener.
Bodhisattvas are enlightened and help others to become enlightened.
Bodhisattva opplyste og hjelper andre med å bli opplyst.
They are the Buddha's helpers. Helping is their job.
De Buddhas hjelpere. Jobben deres å hjelpe.
They are wise, kind and caring.
De kloke, vennlige og omsorgsfulle.
No matter what the trouble is. They are there to help.
Uansett hva som skjer, hjelpen deres der.
Maybe we just jump to the other. One day the Buddha was sitting in the shade of a sala tree. His dearest disciple Ananda came and asked him, "Oh, kind and wise Buddha, what are bodhisattvas like?" The Buddha smiled warmly and said, "Listen carefully and I will tell you."
En dag satt Buddha I skyggen av et sala tre. Hans kjæreste disippel Ananda kom til han og spurte, «O gode og kloke Buddha, hvordan egentlig bodhisattvaer?» Og Buddha smilte varmt og sa, «Hør godt etter, så skal jeg fortelle deg det.»
Bodhisattvas are like snow-covered peaks, because they radiate goodness that is pure and lofty.
Bodhisattvaer som snødekte fjelltopper, fordi de utstråler ren og opphøyd godhet.
They are like the great earth because they nurture all things equally.
De som store moder jord fordi de gir næring til alle ting som uten å gjøre forskjell på dem.
And they are like the great wind because they move freely throughout the world and do not cling to anything.
De som rent vann fordi de renser oss for sorg og smerte.
Yeah, that was not the same one, but they're like they like the great wind because they move freely throughout the world and do not cling to anything. Yeah.
De som sterke vinden fordi de beveger seg fritt gjennom verden uten å feste seg ved noe.
They are like a white lotus blossom because they're not spoiled by anything in the world.
De som hvite lotusblomst fordi ingenting I den verden har skitnet dem til.
They are like a diamond mountain because Mara, the evil one, cannot shake them.
De som et fjell av diamant, fordi Mara, den onde, ikke kan klare å rokke ved dem.
And here I just have to say one thing about Mara, because it's so interesting. Norwegian has some words from Sanskrit. And Mara is in Mareritt. That's the word for a bad dream.
Nightmare.
So actually, a bad dream.
Nightmare.
A nightmare. Yeah, mare. The mare there is the same as in Mara, I think. Yeah, sorry. They are like a great rain because they sprinkle every heart with the sweet teaching of the Buddha.
Det som kraftig regn, fordi det tar, lar Buddhas gode lære flomme til alle hjerter.
They are like the king of fire, because they burn up the firewood of pride. They're not arrogant at all.
De som ildens konge, fordi de brenner opp stolthetens brensel. De har ingen selvgodhet.
They are like the banyan, the king of trees, because they shelter us with loving kindness.
De som banyan-tre, trærnes konge, fordi de gir oss ly med sin kjærlige vennlighet.
They are like the gold-winged Garuda, the king of birds, because they are the most magnificent of all.
De som den gullvingede Garuda, fuglenes konge, fordi de den mest praktfulle av alle.
They are like the Udumbara flower, because they are rare to come across.
De som Udumbara-blomsten, fordi de sjelden å komme over.
They are like migratory birds, because they take only what they need and do not hoard anything.
De som trekkfugler, fordi de bare tar det de trenger, uten å glemme noe, gjemme noe til senere.
They are like the king of bulls, because no one can conquer them.
De som oksenes konge, fordi ingen kan beseire dem.
They are like the king of elephants, because they are tame and majestic.
De som elefantenes konge, fordi de tamme og majestetiske.
They are like the king of lions, because they are brave and noble.
De som løvenes konge, fordi de modige og edle.
They are like the sky, because their kindness covers us all.
De som himmelen, for deres godhet dekker oss alle.
The Buddha said, Ananda, if everyone did the things that bodhisattvas do, they would become bodhisattvas too. With their eyes and hands, they can help others. With the light of their compassion, they can bring peace and happiness to the world.
Buddha sa til Ananda, hvis alle gjorde de samme tingene som bodhisattva gjør, vil de også bli bodhisattvaer. Med øynene og hendene kan de hjelpe andre. Lyset fra deres medfølelse kan spre fred og glede i verden.
Ja, det var alt. Takk.
I have an update that last night the Korean team reported back. They finished the Korean translation of the children's book called Come Back, O Tiger. And this morning the French team reported back too. They finished the French translation of the Song of Enlightenment. And I believe none of the English team finished your assigned text. Am I correct? Okay, next team, Gavin, Nancy.
Perfecting the paramitas. That's our play. At this time, in order to gladden the hearts and minds of all living beings, the Bodhisattva releases all attachments, both within and without. In this way, Dana Paramita can be perfected.
Act 2. Upholding all the precepts and having no attachments, forever separating oneself from arrogance. In this way, Shila Paramita is perfected.
Thank you.
Act 3. Capable of enduring all evil, their minds are unwavering in viewing all living beings with equality, like the great earth that is capable of supporting everything. In this way, the Kanti Paramita is perfected.
Giving rise to the myriad meritorious deeds and cultivating persistently without laxity, the Bodhisattva completes all this without retreating or changing course. Their mighty resolve is undefeatable, and they do not cling to their merits or deny them, but can use them to fulfill all paths to wisdom gates. And in this way, the resolve paramita is perfected. Act 5, Samadhi Meditation. Whether experiencing the Samadhi through the successive stages or not, entering one Samadhi opens the gateway to infinite Samadhi doors, and all its levels are known. This does not go against the verified dharmas of all Samadhi Samapatti. And one accesses rapidly all levels of wisdom. In this way, the Dhyana Paramita is perfected. Yeah.
How are you feeling, everyone? Give me an Amitofo if you're feeling good. Amitofo!
We have lovely gift baskets to all of our amazing staff members that we are going to be passing out now.
So while we were all, as a participant and as participants, while we were, you know, taking naps and enjoying delicious food and lounging around in the beautiful halls outside and inside of the buildings, our precious leaders were running around. And I remember very vividly, like on the first or second day, when Gavin was our leader, and he was just sitting there like with this very stressed look on his face. And it's because he was stressing over us. He was stressing over, you know, our health. Every lunch, like every meal, he had to go in early to cook or to heat up the food. And then just any volunteer who was willing to help out would come and set the table for us. And then Jocelyn, every morning, prepared the food for us too. And so I think we just want to express our appreciation for all of the team leaders. I know that you had to keep in mind everyone's unique needs and everyone's unique positions, from their age to their ethnic backgrounds to their different knowledges, and create, using your own energy and using your own space, a welcoming environment at every session. And it's like a lot. You're expending your energy at every given second that you're in front of your teammates, and you have to, you know, put on a smile. And it reminds me a lot of the it reminds me a lot of the energy that teachers in China would uphold, because I remember I watched this video on South China Morning Post of this teacher right before he entered the classroom. He like practiced how to smile to go into the classroom for his, you know, younglings in high school, and the camera caught all of it. And so I think being a leader is amazing, and especially in a Buddhist setting, I think it all teaches us something to cultivate more tolerance within our hearts. And so at every given second that you get to spend with someone else, and noticing how they pay mind to you and pour benevolent feelings towards you through their words and through their actions, even through their gaze, is very precious. And just thank you so much, our leaders. Nancy. Yes. Ernie, thank you so much for spending your time with us and giving us so much of your jolly goodness. It's really appreciated, I think, from especially blossoming Buddhists. And Gavin, even though, oh, you did so much, Gavin. Like, I don't know, do our team want to give a clapping ovation again? Thank you so much. Thank you, thank you, thank you. And Feta, even though we weren't like all in the same group, the energy that you put into your demonstrations and the laughter we heard from your group and the music and the presentation and also the film, I know that you had a lot of technical help as well, but being able to coordinate all of that is really, really amazing. I think we can all agree. So thank you, Feta.
Also, it's been hush hush, but it should be known that another group leader has their birthday today. So I would like us all to give a big happy birthday to Ernie. Happy. We have cakes in the dining hall. Wait until we get there.
Thank you, Michael.